Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Excellency President Uhuru Kenyatta, Excellencies, Head of States and Governments, Distinguished Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen, I am pleased to join this historic and remarkable first conference on sustainable blue economy in this beautiful city of Nairobi. May I commend and thank my brother, President Uhuru Kenyatta, for hosting and organizing this important conference that seeks to bring the tremendous opportunity of blue economy while conserving our waters for future generations. Somalia potentially stands to gain the most from robust and sustainable blue economy. Somalia is a country of strategic importance with a coastline of over 3,300 kilometers, which is the longest in continental Africa, and an upwelling zone, which is one of the most productive in the region, offers endless potential for ocean-based industries and investment. We have an abundance of untapped reserves from fisheries and marine resources to offshore oil and gas and various minerals resources. My administration recognizes that this largely unexploited resource base can have transformative outcomes in addressing poverty, food insecurity, water shortages, energy needs, and unemployment challenges. We are therefore developing a comprehensive strategy to tap and harness the full potential of sea-based economy in an environmentally sustainable manner. Our Ministry of Port and Marine Affairs promotes to foster partnership for development and upgrading of our geostrategic ports, promotes shipping seafood industry, aquaculture, desalination, and the mineral developments. An equally robust Ministry of Fisheries that is mandated to develop marine resources. We are fully aware of this inextricable link between peace and security and sustainable development. The long period of conflict has no doubt negatively impacted the growth and development of ocean resources in Somalia. However, Somalia is recovering fast, and its sovereignty and border are now fully restored. Excellencies and ladies and gentlemen, as we discussed the potential for sustainable blue economy and the need for investment and industrial follows, it's imperative that we first address all illegal activities along our coastline and unsanctioned exploitation of our marine resources by foreign fishing fleets, illegal charcoal trade to foreign markets, and dumping of toxic waste have become some of the most serious environmental challenges affecting the Somali coast. I hope one of the momentous outcomes of this historic conference would be a strong commitment to cooperate and controlling all illegal offshore activities. My administration will continue to actively seek international cooperation to address these issues. We believe with the transparency and enhanced cooperation and advances in technology and satellite capabilities, we should be able to curb these activities. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, peace and security remains a top agenda for my government. We are strengthening governance, heightening security cooperation for stability, including safe ocean and seas, and we are enhancing resilience to mitigate the harsh effects of climate change and continuing droughts. These efforts have begun to bear fruits, with much interest in our ocean sector already being registered. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I take this opportunity to commit that Somalia is ready for suitable and sustainable partnership and investment to tap into our rich marine resources. I thank you for your attention.